Coming up next on News Live at 6, we'll have complete coverage of the 2019 election. Our reporter Conor Wight will be joining us live from Huntington Hall with the latest at the polls.
And if you have yet to hit the polls, the rain we saw earlier today might be gone. Our CitrusTV weather anchor Adam Sperling will have the full weather forecast.
Then it's time to Boost the Cuse. CitrusTV reporter Liam Crowley will join us live from the Boost the Cuse headquarters at Bird Library. CitrusTV News starts right now.
Is CitrusTV News live at 6, your campus news leader.
It's election day all across America, which means the end of some historically tight races right here at home. Good evening, I'm Lilia Wood.
And I'm Jonah Karp. Tonight we'll tell you all about the new changes to voting in Onondaga County and how people across central New York voted. Joining us, Talking Points anchors Jack Watson with a look at local races and Conor Wight live at the polls. We'll start tonight at Huntington Hall. Conor, how are the polls looking right now?
Right, guys, I spoke to the election chairperson here at the Huntington Hall polling place. She says that turnout has been high. In fact, they've seen more voters cast ballots today than in the past three elections, including the presidential election in 2016. And as of around 6 p.m., that was just over about 70 ballots cast. Now, half of those ballots, she says, have been from students. I spoke to one of those students today. She's a freshman, and it's her first time ever voting in an American election. She's originally from D.C., but she chose to register here in Onondaga County because she believes that her vote will count for more.
Can make a difference, and like I feel like young people voting here has more of an impact than maybe in DC. I definitely think that everyone should get out and vote. I think it's an important step, and a lot of people just don't vote and they don't think they know enough, but just like some quick research like really makes a difference.
For SU students that still want to cast their vote, I can't stress enough how close this place is to campus. If we walk with me right here, that is Marshall Street. So we really are within walking distance of main campus, and polls are open until 9 p.m. tonight. Reporting in Syracuse, I'm Conor White, CitrusTV News.
So we know where you can vote, but which races should we keep an eye out for as the final ballots come in? Our Jack Watson joining us now in studio to let us know. Jack?
Well, Jonah, in the waning hours of Election Day, there's still a lot to pay attention to as those results come in. Here's what's on the line tonight. First, we have that Onondaga County executive race, Ryan McMahon and Tony Malavenda in one of the most heated local races in recent memory, one accusing the other of taking part in a Ponzi scheme. McMahon is looking to continue the unbeaten streak of Republicans in that office dating back to the 60s. Malavenda, the local business owner, looks to reverse that trend today. Another important county position up for grabs, the county comptroller looking to watch over the finances of Onondaga County, are incumbent Matthew Beadnell and Democratic challenger Marty Masterpool. You might recognize Marty Masterpool as a former Syracuse mayoral candidate, and Beadnell took over as comptroller at the beginning of this year, chosen by Ryan McMahon. Another big one to keep your eye on is the district attorney race. Bill Fitzpatrick's tenure has spanned multiple decades. He's held that position since the early 90s, but the conservative Gary Levine and Democrat Chuck Keller each want to put an end to that. From Fitzpatrick, if you're a City of Syracuse voter, you'll choose two councilors at large and another five councilors for the Common Council. They're all up for election, and you'll vote on what could be new districts for the council on the back of your ballot. Like Conor said, the polls don't close until 9 this evening, so we'll have a better idea of how the race is going in just a few hours. There's still time to get there, though, if you haven't already, guys.
Thanks, Jack. So if you're looking to cast your ballot in those remaining 3 hours, will you have to face the rain that has been falling on Syracuse all day?
Well, weather anchor Adam Sperling has the answer. Adam?
Well, guys, the short answer is no, thankfully. The rain has actually stopped by now. It's about 40 degrees here in Syracuse, low winds, and we're finally drying off from all the rain we saw today. And now, in Syracuse, due to Daylight Savings Day, even though we really enjoyed having that extra hour of sleep, the sun is setting a lot earlier, and that's not really great for my morale, really. But taking a look at the rest of election night, temperatures are going to be staying around that 41 to 40 point. It's going to be 40 degrees by 9 p.m. It's going to be cloudy all throughout the night, But 6 to 8 mile per hour winds will make the feels like temperatures drop to about 35 degrees by 9 p.m., even lower by the time we get to 10 p.m. Now, looking at our Wednesday weather, it's going to be about 35 degrees if you're waking up early. We're going to be seeing some clouds. Now, by noon, it's going to get up to 40 degrees. But again, don't let that 40 fool you. It's going to feel like 30s all day. And by 6 p.m., temperature is going to be about 38 degrees. And we will be staying dry through all of Wednesday. But is that a promise I can keep for the rest of the week? Well, you'll just have to tune in for my full weather forecast to find out. Jonah, Lilia, back to you.
Thanks, Adam. So not a sunny day throughout, but the weather was clear for those who got to the polls early this morning. CitrusTV reporter Greg Bradbury was at Nottingham High School to see what brought people to the polls so early.
...and haven't changed their ways for years, including William Sovic.
I always vote, ever since I was 18. Every day, always early.
But some are choosing not to vote today and instead already got their sticker.
This year, having the ability to vote early. See, I've already voted, so I didn't have to worry about doing that today.
Sandra Davis was at the polls as a poll watcher this morning, but voted early so that she could go with her daughter.
And she wouldn't have been able to vote except absentee, and that's a process too. And this way, her vote counted right away. Didn't have to wait for the absentee ballots to be counted. So,
early voting has been open since October 26th, and the unofficial numbers from the Onondaga County Board of Elections say that 8,487 people voted early. In addition, 3,084 absentee ballots have been received. The goal is to increase voter accessibility.
I mean, anything that increases access to voting and getting folks out to the polls that wouldn't otherwise be able to or wouldn't otherwise have the ability to is always good.
Voters appreciate the changes, but for Sovic,
this is just as easy.
He will still be coming to the polls on each election day. For CitrusTV News, I'm Greg Bradbury.
Greg, Onondaga County added new technology to the polling process this year with iPads at check-in. CitrusTV reporter Nicole Weaving learned why the county made this change and what the voters thought.
iPads are the newest addition to the polling process in Onondaga County. Not for casting your vote, but for checking in. Jamesville DeWitt High School poll site manager Joe Smith said this change came from the decision to implement early voting this year.
We needed a way to A, make it possible for all voters to go to an early voting site and be able to vote. And then also you had to have that information included what ballot needed to be printed for them.
Most people, like Stephanie Fair, thought the iPads made the check-in process more efficient.
It was very quick. It seemed much easier than the folks working, having to thumb through a book and try to find a name. People also didn't have to figure out what ward they were in or what area they were in. So it just seemed very quick.
Voters can now simply use their license to sign in and vote.
It was just nice and easy. I thought it was great. I can't imagine it getting any better.
Despite the iPads, Onondaga County hasn't fully entered the digital era as paper ballots are still used to cast votes.
The advantage of having a paper ballot is that in the case of some sort of technical glitch, we can rescan all those paper ballots.
Fair prefers that the voting process remains the same.
This seems to be a little more personal, where you can fill it out and put it right in the machine yourself.
While Neil Bronstein wouldn't mind a change to voting machines as long as the results of the election are reported accurately.
Whatever protects the integrity of the system is fine by me.
I'm Nicole Weaving, CitrusTV News.
The polls in Onondaga County have been open for a little over 12 hours now. I was at Nottingham High School when the polls opened at 6 this morning and spoke to some of the first voters. Many people have been asking themselves questions before they cast their ballots today. But for William Sovic, he knows one thing.
People that I did not vote for. I mean, I left the whole column.
And then he started asking the questions.
Why are you up early?
Sovic is one of the many people that voted early this morning at Nottingham High School.
Want me to start asking questions?
Maeve Mullaney even came on her birthday.
How old are you?
Four.
It's your birthday today.
Democratic poll watcher Sandra Davis took advantage of early voting in New York, but still came to polls before 6 a.m. to ensure everything is up and running.
we really have to try to thank those people, those election inspectors that give up a full day. That's a long day until 9 o'clock. Think about it. Mm-hmm. Just sitting here waiting for people to come in, but they enjoy it too.
By 7:45, 41 people voted here at Nottingham High School, and one person made sure to cast his vote, and his name is on the ballot.
And so, for me, this is definitely competitive. It is neck and neck, and you know, I think we have a real clear shot at winning this thing. I'm excited.
So Vic had some advice for youngins like Maeve.
People just really have to be involved, you know? If people have to learn. If you don't know history, you're gonna repeat it.
But the only question Maeve is considering is there anything better than voting on your birthday? Well, at least she got a sticker and only has 14 more years until she can vote herself. Nottingham High School is 10 minutes away from campus, but there are many different places to vote in Onondaga County. The polls will be open until 9 tonight.
Coming up next, the rain might be going away, but are you ready to see snow instead? Adam Sperling will be back to tell you when we can expect to see that first snowfall.
And CitrusTV reporter Peyton Smith tells us how Central New York is celebrating 100 years of women's suffrage in the United States. Don't go away.
All right, Monroe.
You ready?
Monroe. Here we go. The butterfly.
Ready?
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable. With you that time you felt most alone. And with you when you realized you would never be. They were with you when you shared your love with the world. And with you when she became your world. Your girls have never left you. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them?
You don't know mine.
Knowing your breasts can save your life.
While 2019 is a local election in Central New York, this election day marks a special milestone for women's suffrage.
CitrusTV reporter Peyton Smith was at Jamesville DeWitt High School to find out why.
Less than a week after Halloween, some soon-to-be voters were greeted with another treat at the polls.
Well, what's on your shirt?
Milk and flag. A sticker.
Oh, what'd you get the sticker for?
Voting.
That treat would be the I Voted sticker, a badge worn proudly by those who've completed their civic duty on Election Day. Onondaga County Election Inspector Norma Feldman says they've been a hit.
They love it. We're running out of them.
But this year, the polling station at Jamesville DeWitt High School is handing out a second token so voters remember this special Election Day.
This year, this sticker commemorates 100 years of women's suffrage in New York State.
Congress passed the 19th Amendment in 1919, giving women the right to vote across the United States. Feldman says she's proud to share this milestone with others.
We are celebrating. That was a big change, so it's an important thing to commemorate.
Voter Samantha Gingold says it means a lot to share this anniversary with her daughter at the polls.
I think just realizing that it's been so long and that
it is something that had to be fought for. It just kind of reinforces that every vote counts, and it's important to cast your vote, even if you think that it's not making a difference. It is.
Gingold also says she votes in every election, no matter how big or small, because women had to fight to earn this right. Peyton Smith, Citrus TV News.
Well, it was rainy today, but that might turn to snow soon.
Oh boy, well, maybe Adam Sperling will have some better news. Adam?
Not this time, Jonah, unfortunately. Well, right now, it's not raining, it's not snowing. It's about 40 degrees, and through the night, it won't rain either, but temperatures will feel like the low 30s. And as we wake up tomorrow, temperatures are going to be about 37 degrees. We're going to be seeing some low to moderate winds, not too bad on the wind chill form, not too bad with wind chills, but there will be no rain throughout the day. But unfortunately, we see our first snow planner of the semester. It's going to be 42 degrees at 9 a.m. It's not going to start snowing for a while. It's going to be raining throughout 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. to 3 p.m. But when we get to 6 p.m., it's going to be 36 degrees. But unfortunately, that's enough for it to start snowing. It's going to be snowing through past 9 p.m. It's going to be 33 degrees by 9 p.m. Your chance of precipitation is highest around 1 to 2 p.m., but it probably will be snowing on and off for the rest of the night into early Friday, where temperatures are going to start out at about 28 degrees. It will be remaining snowing. We might be getting some wintry mix of snow and rain, but by 12 p.m., it's going to be 33 degrees with some clouds, and by 6 p.m., 29 degrees. No rain, no snow, but unfortunately, temperatures are going to be consistently dropping below freezing for a long while. Lilia, Jonah?
Thanks, Al.
14 hours and counting, Boost the Cuse has begun on campus to help raise money for SU.
This is the third SU fundraiser that has held, this is the third year SU has held the fundraising event. And coming up on News Live at 6, CitrusTV reporter Liam Crowley will be live inside of Bird Library with the latest on the ongoing event.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
Hey, Dad. One, two, three.
Dad! You saved me.
Dad?
Are you okay?
I'm fine, dear.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
You're watching Citrus TV News with Jonah Karp, Lilia Wood, Adam Sperling, and Liam Crowley. Citrus TV News, your campus news leader.
The third annual Boost the Cuse fundraiser started this morning at 4 a.m. and for the first time will last 44 hours. CitrusTV reporter Liam Crowley joins us live from Boost the Cuse headquarters happening right now. Liam?
Thanks, Lilia. I'm here inside Boost the Cuse headquarters at Bird Library where the event started at 4 a.m. this morning. Earlier this week, I spoke with two representatives from Boost the Cuse to discuss how this year's event is different from last year's.
So in the past, we haven't had much of an on-campus presence. We've more targeted alumni off campus, you know, through social media channels, over the phone, just, you know, hitting them with different emails. This year, we're really trying to get the student body involved.
Syracuse University alum Kim Infante says her connection to SU is what drives her to make the fundraiser special.
I don't think I could love Syracuse University more than I do. This place absolutely changed my life. And so when I have the opportunity as an employee now to let others see how Syracuse changed their lives, there's just nothing like it. I always say, when you're orange, you just know. You get it. Like, it's something really special about this place, and Boost the Cuse is about tapping into that.
He says the goal this year is to reach 5,000 donors. Live inside Boost the Cuse headquarters at Bird Library, Liam Crowley, CitrusTV News.
Thanks, Liam.
Oh, we'll be keeping an eye on just how much money SU brings in and if any sports alum will be giving this year. Right, Karl?
Yeah, Jonah, sports alum or sports broadcasting alum. You know, I hear Mike Tirico's in town this week, so we'll see if he's got anything to give. But coming up in sports, the men's soccer team is in overtime in the first ACC tournament. Full details on that. Plus, the women's basketball team opens their season tonight. Find out why the orange opponent shouldn't be overlooked. Also, Jim Boeheim's squad got a trip to Italy to warm up now for this season. The season starts full speed tomorrow. All you need to know is coming up next.
Fancy pants peanut butter? A big screen television? You haven't even bought a sofa yet. A motorcycle? When your father finds out, he's gonna flip his shoes with two buckles? What do you even need two buckles for? Mr. Big Shot. Buying whiskey shots for everybody in the bar. From the looks of it, I'd say nobody even remembers. Feed the pig.
Well, Thomas, you've got prediabetes. But with more exercise and a change in diet, it can be reversed.
I've tried exercising. It just makes me hungry for bacon.
I love bacon, too. And who really likes to exercise?
Not me.
Me neither.
Nobody. So we're good?
What? Oh, you still have prediabetes. Big time.
One in three adults has prediabetes. That means it could be you, your favorite brother, your other brother,
yes.
You, your football buddy, your football buddy, you, your plumber.
Breathe right into your foot.
Your plumber's masseuse.
Yes.
You, your dog walker, your cat jogger. With early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. Take the risk test at doihaveprediabetes.org.
And now, your CitrusTV Sports Report.
The men's soccer team is in ACC tournament action as we speak. Hello, I'm Karl Moeglein. Let's get right to where we are right now down in Chapel Hill where the Syracuse men's soccer team. 90 minutes, not enough today. The 10th-seeded Orange have pushed the 7th-seeded Heels to double overtime. Time the game still scoreless. SU though outshot UNC in regulation by a margin of 5-2. Still going on there in Chapel Hill. That's to keep Syracuse's season alive. On Jim Boeheim Court tonight, the women's basketball team opens its season. It's the Orange's first game without star point guard Tiana Monacahia. Syracuse rallied around the Australian this summer after she announced her breast cancer diagnosis. So without Tiana on the floor, but with her every step of the way, SU takes on Ohio tonight. The Bobcats will certainly not be an easy opponent to start the season. Last year, Ohio was a game away from advancing to the NCAA tournament. In the WNIT, the Bobcats made it all the way to the Elite Eight. Syracuse has won all three matchups in Syracuse history. The difference maker this year for Ohio could be CeCe Hooks. Last season, she was All-MAC First Team and Defensive Player of the Year. Coach Q says that for Syracuse, Ohio is a perfect first opponent.
It's exciting, you know. Anytime you can get on the floor and compete against another university, and obviously playing Ohio, it's gonna be a tough game. They're a very good team. Won 30 games last year, and you know they have players that are on the Wade Trophy watch list. I mean they're a very good program, and obviously you know we schedule our games and we pick our schedule, so we definitely want to have a challenging schedule, and our first game is gonna be a tremendous challenge. So I'm very excited to see our kids compete against a great team.
Staying on the hardwood, the men start their regular season with a bang this year. The ACC schedule has expanded to 20 games. That brings an extra big challenge to the Dome on opening night. The Cuse will have to take down the defending national champions to start the season 1-0. Virginia is ranked number 11 to start the year. They come to the Carrier Dome, but not with a lot of the players they had from last year's team. Kyle Guy, Ty Jerome, they're both gone from the championship squad. Still, Tony Bennett has plenty of weapons. Forward Mamadi Diakite is expected to fill a bigger role. Additionally, point guard Kihei Clark returns after starting 20 games his freshman year. Syracuse looks to snap a 3-game losing streak against the Cavaliers. And winter sports are starting just as fall sports hit the closing stretch. Across the board, Syracuse continues to have success and receive recognition. Carolyn Hoffman's 2-goal performance against number 5 Louisville propelled Orange Fields hockey to victory. It also earned her ACC Offensive Player of the Week. Hoffman is Syracuse's third straight ACC Player of the Week for field hockey. Meanwhile, on the ice, Mae Batherson was named CHA Rookie of the Week. The Nova Scotia native scored 2 goals and picked up an assist against RIT this weekend.
All right, Karl, a lot going on in Syracuse sports. Big game tomorrow for men's basketball. It's Virginia, the defending champions. What do you expect out of this team this year?
I mean, more than anything, you've got to expect a lot of energy. You think there's a lot of young players who want to prove themselves, and that's really exciting. There's a lot of opportunities early in this season, starting in with Virginia. I mean, you can look at it as a good thing or a bad thing. I like to be forever the optimist. I know, Lilia, you like to, too. So definitely keep the hopes up and see if they can take on this challenge.
All right, thanks so much, Karl. Coming up next, we'll have one last weather check for the week. Stay tuned.
Call me Maxi, but I prefer Tripod. I was your above-average four-legged homie, and then wham, bam, minivan. Some people pity me. Now that's lame. I still run, fetch, and swim. And the ladies love me. I'm the ultimate wingman. Just don't ask me to high-five.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Mm-hmm. Let's crawl. Mm-hmm. Let's crawl. Mm-hmm. Hey, yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Mm-hmm. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl.
Welcome back. We are joined by weather anchor Adam Sperling. So Adam, how's the rest of the week going?
Well, that's a loaded question. There's some good and then there's some bad. See, tomorrow we're going to be seeing a clear day, high of 44, low of 35. But by Thursday, you're seeing the first real snow of the semester, high of 42, but low of 27. Whew, that's well into freezing. Friday, we're going to be seeing maybe some AM snow, but likely it's going to be a pretty clear day. Still low of 25 degrees. Saturday, we're going to be seeing a high of 39, low of 31. And then Sunday is not looking great either.
Wow, I'm not looking forward to that snow. Thank you, Adam. Now, in honor of Election Day, we decided to have a poll of our own, even if it isn't quite politics related.
We asked our viewers on Twitter if they were ready for that first big snowfall, and these are the results so far. Yeah,
really?
Resounding no. I think that's a safe
I know, but 44% go Cuse.
Okay, go Cuse. Yeah, I'm not ready for it either. All right, that's all the time we have for you tonight. Hey, be sure to check us out on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram at CitrusTV News, and check out our website at CitrusTV.com. From all of us here, I'm Jonah Karp.
And I'm Lilia Wood. Enjoy the rest of your evening, Syracuse, and it's not too late to get out there and vote.